let's talk about cost. The term cost here is an aggregate term. It considers a few different factors. First factor is protocol speed, so TCP, SMB, NFS, things like that. The storage medium cost, so this is what additional storage is required to provide redundancy, which is a big deal, particularly if you're working in enterprise, and achieve some total amount of usable storage besides what's, you know, being cordoned off for the redundancy sake. There's system requirements as well to support CPU, RAM, and RAID cards, as well as the management overhead of each of these systems. So first, let's talk the cost of block storage. In order to provide redundancy, it's typical that this is coupled with expensive hardware and network links to prevent disruption and data loss. Typically uses a RAID or redundant array of inexpensive disks for parity and high availability. This often requires that there's a whole bunch of extra hardware that doesn't actually get used to the end user anyway, but rather is used for parity or, you know, a backup essentially. If one of the other disks fails, these other disks can take on that role and you won't lose any of your data. Often sold by vendors with specialized hardware and software to provide the optimum experience. So you can think of an organization like NetApp, who's going to bring this huge storage array in and take care of everything for you. But there are many additional costs associated with that. And it can be expensive to scale due to the above redundancy and specialized hardware requirements. So if you went and bought, 100 terabytes from NetApp and now your organization is growing a lot faster and you need to add on to that, that's going to cost you again. That's going to be a lot more money for you. So now let's talk about some of the considerations of cost for file storage. Often relies on block storage and therefore inherits many of the same hardware and networking costs to achieve high availability. File storage is not typically handling the disks on its own, but rather is, like I said, written on top of something else like block storage to handle that for it. The scalability is often affected due to relying on the same constraints that block storage has. And the requirement for the configuration and management of network shares by a separate system, so think like a Windows server serving these files out to the entirety of your corporation or your organization, really requires its own management overhead. So there's going to be some additional hardware costs and there's going to be some additional people costs to managing file storage. And now let's talk about the cost of object storage. The nice thing about object storage is it can use off-the-shelf hardware and provide highly effective redundancy using what's called erasure coding in most cases. I know that MinIO uses that without the need for expensive RAID hardware, which is really important because now you're starting to cut away from the hardware costs and really be able to pile that into additional data storage. So you could buy, additional drives or you don't have to buy a RAID card. The protocol is very efficient, relying on standard REST API over TCP and HTTP. It can easily scale any endpoint simply by adding additional backends, as I mentioned earlier, that are transparent to the end user. What I mean by that, again, is that the end user doesn't have to know where that's located or what type of hardware it is or anything like that, but you can just continue to add backends. And the front end interface for the end user, all they know is that they're writing files and continuing to write files and they just have more and more space that they can use. And on the back end, you're just adding them wherever it's convenient, wherever works for your organization and whatever type of hardware or equipment that you want to use, you can continue to add backends. And then lastly, it's inexpensive to scale this globally as endpoints can be placed in geographically diverse locations and replicated to automatically. So let's say that you had a front end object storage interface that was storage.myorganization.org. And you wanted to make this as fast as possible, regardless of where your employees were. Well, now what you could do is replicate all of the data to multiple different object storage points around the globe. And then when they hit that endpoint, there could be some geolocation done and they would be sent to the one that is going to be the fastest for them, regardless of where they are. So that makes it really economical and really efficient and effective for organizations to scale out globally.